In this lesson, we will discuss the categories of pipe flow problems. When analyzing fluid flow through a pipe system, there are many parameters you need to consider. For example, fluid characteristics such as density and viscosity, pipe characteristics such as diameter, length, and roughness, the rate of flow, which is expressed using velocity or volumetric flow rate, and finally, terms related to viscous losses, such as pressure drop and head loss. When designing pipe systems, we often are limited by one or more of these parameters. Engineers have found it useful to classify pipe flow problems into three categories. In type 1 problems, we are given a pipe system with known characteristics, such as diameter, total length, and roughness. We also know the rate of flow and the fluid parameters such as density and viscosity. We want to find quantities that are related to viscous losses, such as pressure drop across the pipe system or the head loss. In type 2 problems, we again are given a pipe system with known characteristics and know the fluid parameters. But now we are given the pressure drop or head loss and want to find the velocity or volumetric flow rate. In type 3 problems, we know the pressure drop or head loss, the rate of flow, and fluid parameters. We want to find a characteristic of the pipe system, such as diameter, total length, or roughness. Type 1 problems are often straightforward to solve because the quantities required to calculate the friction factor are known. However, type 2 and type 3 problems often require an iterative process because the velocity and diameter are needed to calculate the friction factor. Regardless of the category, we begin the analysis of all pipe flow problems by first selecting a control volume and then applying the conservation of energy equation.